Hey everybody, welcome back, and we are stepping into our second mission on our playthrough of the Hunters from Consimpress. We're looking at a November 1939 departure date from Kiel, as we have gotten the U-33 refitted and restocked and repaired after our last mission. I know I was going to say I was going to go over, you know, putting the torpedoes out, but honestly, it's kind of boring. It's just steam torpedoes in the tubes, in the fore tubes, in the aft tube, and then load up on electrics for the rest of them. Real difficult, real tough. Yeah, I know. All right, so we're going to go ahead, and we are going to appeal to Admiral Doinitz to get a choice, to get to choose our own patrol route. And I do that on a one. Now, Doinitz almost did. I'm sure if I'd have done a little bit better in the last patrol, he might have given it to me. But nope, I have to go and do what Kriegsmarine High Command wants me to do. And through that is going to be, we're looking at, what is that, a four is the British Isles again. That kind of makes sense. All right, so get that jotted down. And we're going to be doing the British Isles again, sorting out of Kiel on a bleak and miserable November morning. And we're going to go ahead and start off in transit. Roll for events. There's a six, that's a nothing. We continue on to the next box, which puts us in transit again. And we've got a five, which is nothing. And now we're off the west coast of the British Isles. Actually, we're probably off the northwest coast this time. We're going to go around a little bit north, maybe scout out Scapa Flow. Let's see if we run into anything here. Four is nothing. Wow, what is this? We've got to have the worst luck. We've come across a grand total of two ships in our missions. And then a four is, again, nothing. Oh my, I don't know if this is good luck or bad luck. And about 2 weeks out, we go ahead and decide to start heading back. Three, again, nothing. Eh, maybe I shouldn't have switched to these dice. All right, so we head back. Of course, we're hearing radio chatter. All the other submarines are being so successful. And transit six is nothing. And then transit back into Kiel, we get nothing. All right, well, that was probably the most boring, unexciting patrol of the entire war. Nothing. Nada. Zilch. We didn't even see a fishing trawler. Again, I don't know if that's good luck or bad luck, or it just is what it is. But the good thing is, we do get the guys home for Christmas, and they get to manage to spend Christmas while the sub is being refitted. And you know what? I'm going to give them off until after New Year's, and so we're not going to take off for the next patrol until January of 1940. And let's see, there's something special about the 7A that it automatically gets pulled off the line at a certain point and gets replaced with a different submarine. Let's see if I can find that real quick. Ah, okay, all 7As were withdrawn from service totally in December of 1940, so we've still got a year to go before they pull us out of this sub. Unless, of course, we get sunk. All right, so we're looking at January 1940. We're going to request a patrol mission again, although after the last uneventful mission, I'm not sure if Doinitz is going to permit it. Ah, again, he got real close, but he made a compelling argument, but he decided, nope, 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 nope. So, let's take a look at what our patrol zone we get assigned to is the British Isles again. They're saying, nope, you're going out there until you actually find something and sink it or do something a little bit more memorable than the last mission. Alright, so we sally forth out of Kiel. Transit is a 5. Is a nothing. Going to transit again. 10 is a nothing. Now off the British Isles again. Hell, we'll even take a fishing trawler at this point. 6 is a ship and an escort. All right, a single ship and an escort. Let's go ahead and shift over to the combat chart. Let's take a look at what kind of ship we run into. 6. Ooh, I believe that's a tanker. I'm fairly certain that's a tanker. That is a tanker. Yes. Tankers are delicious targets. Alrighty. Let's see what type of tanker it is. Or which tanker it is. We got some percentile dice here. We end up looking at 67. Which is the 9,900 ton Caledonia. Oh, that's actually a pretty big one. So I'll go ahead and mark this down on our sheet here. 9,900 ton tanker Caledonia. That name sounds familiar. All right, so tanker, and it is under. Oh, all tankers are, well, let's see. Large freighter tanker under 10,000. Okay, so it's an under 10,000 tons. So she gets 3 hit boxes. And since I'm using the random escorts, crew qualities. Let's see, 6. Uh-oh. Actually, I don't think there are elite. At least not until, yeah, not in 39 or 40. Best they can be is veteran. So, ooh, this is going to be a little bit of a rough one. Now we got veteran escort. And what time of day is it? We got daytime. So we're going to come in submerged. And we're going to be at medium range. And you know what? We're going to put 3 torpedoes at her. 3 steam torpedoes at her. Tempted to put a 4th one on there, but I think that may be a little bit overkill. Of course, sometimes we may need that. All right, we're medium range. Let's take a look at any modifiers. Do not. Nope. Nope, no modifiers. So I need a 7 or less with each torpedo. On 2d6. First torpedo. Hit. Yes. Nice. Making up for the last 2 patrols. Hit. All right. All right. 3 torpedoes may have been overkill. All right. So 2 torpedoes hit. Now we got to roll to see if they're duds. These are 7A steams. So they dud on a 1 or a 2. 1 is a dud. Well, that is annoying. But 1 torpedo still manages to get through. Let's take a look, see at how much damage we do to that freighter. Two is 3 points of damage. Yes, that slams right into her side, breaks her back. Big, massive, nasty eruption. And she goes to the bottom. Yes, we like that. All right. And I'm pretty sure I do have to do 1 round of escort detection. All right, so we got 1 round of, well, at least 1 round of detection to try to go through. Let's take a look at the chart. Let's see, modifiers. It was a G7A during the day, so that's going to be a +1. I believe that's it. I think the escort doesn't give any modifiers to detection. It just affects how many hits I take. look at that real quick, because that should be easy to find. Variable escort quality. Yeah, it's just affects how many hits I take, not the actual modifier to detect. All right, so we've got a plus one on the dice roll, because I used a steam torpedo during the daytime, so they were able to see the bubbles and track it back to where I was coming from. So we need a 7 or less to be undetected. Hey, there we go. Undetected. Managed to put 3 torpedoes into the side of the Caledonia. Watch her slip beneath the waves and snuck away from the veteran escorts. That is a good day. We consider that a very, very good day. So, go ahead and reload our torpedoes. Now we're going to be using some electrics. We got 3 electrics in the tubes now. And shift the camera here a little bit. All right, well, we're going to go ahead and continue on our mission. We're in the British Isles still. Let's see what we come up with. Have yet to run... Oh, 2 capital ship. Yes. We like the capital ships. Which capital ship are we going to run into? Roll a D10 for that one. It's 3. It's the Carrier Courageous. All right. Shifting back over here. We have the Carrier Courageous. It's a capital ship. So she automatically starts off with 5 hits. And she automatically has an escort. Let's roll for the quality. Whoops, not a D10. A D6 for the quality of the escort. Three. That is going to be, I believe, normal. Yep. Normal trained. All right. They've got escort and escort trained, but they don't have escort green. Oh well. All right. Well, what time? Let's see. What is what time of day do we manage to catch the carrier? 3 is during the daytime, so we're going to come in submerged. And you know what? We're not even going to risk it. We're going to stay back at long range because we've got 3 electrics. So let's go ahead and fire the 3 electrics off. Let's take a look at what we need to hit. Long range is a 6. Let's see, modifiers. Okay, this isn't a steam, this is just a normal electric. All right, so we're looking at 6s to hit. You know, part of me wants to fire off that steam torpedo, but I do not want those escorts to have that modifier for firing off the steam torpedo. So, let's hope we can get some good rolls here. First torpedo, miss. Second torpedo, miss. Third torpedo. That's a hit. All right, well, at least one of them slammed into her side. Okay, I don't think it's going to be enough to sink her. Of course, we got to roll to see if it's a dud. 5? No, it's fine. No dud there. And now the damage is going to be... Yeah, I'm not even my best roll. I'm not going to be able to sink her. Let's see how much damage I can do to her. 6-1 damage. Probably exploded right at her strongest torpedo line armor. Oh well, let's see. Well, we're going to have to suffer lots of escort. Well, not lots of escort attacks, but I can pretty much guarantee the escorts will be swarming around us. All over the place. Let's see what... okay, so it's +1 because it's a capital ship. Let's see. And minus one for being long range. Okay, and no modifiers because I use the electric torpedoes. So, that's a straight roll, eight or less, and we managed to get away. 11, oh, nope. And, yeah, they detected me. Okay. So, it is a normal trained escort. And that is... Let's see, take a look at the chart. Let's see, fuel modifiers. Yeah, there's really no modifiers for the damage, so 2d6. Let's see, that's a 5, is 1 hit. So we managed to take 1 hit, and let's go ahead and roll for that. This is a 26. Which is going to be 3.7 millimeter flak. I don't have a 3.7 millimeter flak. I got a 2 centimeter flak. Damage results cannot be applied or ignored. Okay, so had I had a 3.7 millimeter flak, it would have been damaged. But unfortunately, fortunately, I do not have one, so there is no damage. So now we got to see if I can try to slip away. So it's another detection attempt. It is going to be a 7 because it was previously detected last turn. And no other modifiers apply. So 8, nope, but detected again. So that means they're going to hammer me again. It is a 3, ineffective attacks. All right. Try to slip away again. Keep rolling every time you get detected. You got to roll damage, and then if you do get detected, then you got to roll the detection again after the damage is rolled. See if we can get away. 6. All right, there we go. Managed to slink away. I'm not going to continue going after. I've got 2 torpedoes at best. Both steams. One in the forward tube, one in the aft tube. That would just be... A bad, yeah, we're not gonna, yeah. We had a chance to put down a carrier, but we failed. Oh, well, at least we got a tanker so far. All right, so continuing on the patrol in the British Isles. Let's see, it's a 5. Is a single ship, an unescorted ship. Nice. Let's see what we get. 3 is going to be, I believe, a small freighter. That is a small freighter. And let's roll to see which small freighter. Where's my percentiles? We got an OT-4. I think we had an OT-4 last time. No, OT-4 is the 4,800-ton Royal Scepter. Let's go ahead and mark down that we went after the Courageous, but didn't get it. And now the 4,800-ton light freighter. Oh, forgot to refill our torpedo tubes after the last encounter. So, it's a small freighter. Small freighters always start off on the 2 chart. What time of day do we manage to catch her? On dice. 6, nighttime, all right. Well, y'all know what's going to happen now. This is going to be a surface attack at close range. And we are going to open up with our deck guns first, because we don't have to worry about rolling for any escort. So go ahead and take our 2 ammo, because you can fire up to 2 shots with your deck gun. And let's see what we need. I think it's an 8. Minus 1 for night attack. Yep. Just minus 1. So we need 7s or less to hit with the deck gun. Now we got a 3. That's a hit. No need to roll for duds. These shells are good. And 8. So 1 hit with the deck gun. And straight up damage. We got a 4, which is 1 point of damage. Put several shells into her side. And we are going to continue, but now we have to check for detection. Because they put out the call and, help us, we're being attacked. And now we have to roll to see if they actually show up. And the modifiers are... I don't know if there's any modifiers for that. I think it's just a straight up dice roll. To check to see if the escorts show up. Okay. Unescorted ship targets, night surface attack. Oh, yeah. U-boats conducting a night surface attack may fire an immediate second salvo. Okay. During the first round only, a night surface attack also suffers from a negative modifier and escort, but the U-boats cannot exceed test deck. All right, that's right. So I get to fire. All right, so we're going to go ahead and fire off steam torpedo from the front. We don't have to worry about checking detection yet because we get to check with all of our weapon systems before rolling for detection. And this is going to be close range. It's going to be an 8. It's going to be minus 1 for night, which is a 7. And that's all the modifiers. All right, good. So we managed to put the torpedo into our side. And watch this be a dud. Haven't had many duds yet. No, all right, she's good. And basically anything I roll is going to sink her. 6, yeah, glancing blow, but it's 1 point of damage. It's enough to put her down. So, yes, that is our second ship we've managed to sink. Very successful patrol so far, although hardly makes up for the last patrol. So now we are done. We've probably done 3.5 weeks off the coast of the British Isles, transiting back to Kiel. Let's see if we have anything happen to us in Kiel. That's a 6. That's not going to be anything. Fairly certain. Transit, you don't have a lot of... don't have a lot of opportunities for engagement and transit. Yeah, 2, 3, and 12 are the only ones. And then transiting back into Kiel itself, which is a 7, which is nothing. All right, so we managed to pull back in. There's no damage to us. It's been a successful patrol this time. And let's see, what is that? That is... math is hard. That's a 14. No, that's 007. 14,700 tons. All right, much better. That was a good patrol. We like that. That was a successful patrol, so we marked that down as successful. Unfortunately, we don't get to check for any skill increases for the crew because it takes 3 successful patrols. And, well, as we remember, our second one wasn't all that successful. So we're just going to go ahead and load up our ammo for next time. And we're going to be down for a month refit. Nobody was injured, nothing like that. So when we come back, March 1940, and hopefully this stunning success that we had will give us the opportunity to convince Doinitz to let us pick our own mission area. Because you know what? My captain really, really, really wants to go to the coast of Spain, you know. Maybe go ashore real quick, pick something up for the wife. We'll see. We're not telling Doinitz that's what we want to do. All right, folks. That's what I got for tonight. Questions, comments, concerns, complaints, criticisms in the comment section. I'll see everybody next time. See ya!